great things about him is he has an enormous amount of security, confidence, and jumping ability. This quadruple, the triple rather, toe loop, he was playing it very carefully. See what this move is. There was the quadruple toe. Now that was as clean a quadruple toe as there is.
Back when we first learned about his knee injury early in the season, a lot of people, us included, we really wondered whether he should be out there competing. Why not have it taken care of? Go under the knife, fix the meniscus, they can clean it out easily.
Oh, well, he eked that out. Really, that was a beautiful combination, which he changed. He inserted that after the planned one earlier he elected not to do.
And Dickie seems to know what he's doing, not only on the ice, but with his injury, because it's worked. He keeps winning and winning, and at the end of the season, he plans to have surgery. And it's held up.
Oh, beautiful. Look at him hop out of that on the half landing. That was probably because he knew he was a little bit out of shape and out of position, rather, to get into the next move for. Donut position. Now, aside from the use of some of the earlier Scheherazade music, there's little here that is essentially Nijinsky, except for that move that we saw right there. Straight out of Afternoon of a Fawn, one of the most famous of Nijinsky's creations. He doesn't really have a very clean, elegant, classical style. Legs are not always stretched. Toes are not always pointed. But there's an excitement about his skating that's always interesting. Practice, this combination spin was first rate. It's always harder to do it under the pressure of an overall competition.
And he says that move has gotten harder and harder with his knee and with age.
And with his hips. You know, it's very hard to... Too many people are stretching in ways that they should not be. Even Nijinsky was more concerned with the speed and the force of a jump than with the height of it. That's a pure Nijinsky move. Straight out of Spectre de la Rose. This final spin combination. The head position there, just awful. But the rest of it certainly maintains your attention. You know, you cannot lose interest in him.
5'8".
Jeffrey
Five
Buttle
eight.
Watching Five and waiting eight. To see if he'll Five win the gold medal. You got to doubt it at this point, but tremendous day for him here in Detroit. Plushenko's marks, look at those, Dick. 5'8", 5'9".
Well,
in the second set now in the 5-7 up to 5-9 range, and clearly the best.
Well, I mean, he was awfully good. He's awfully exciting. It wasn't his best program. I think we've seen him do far, far more imaginative and greater programs, but this was really first rate right down the line.